making my first ink. It was a frustrating, difficult thing. But in the end, there wasn't a sense of relief. It was more a sense of loss that I didn't have to work on that anymore. You know, I don't know what it is about ink making. It's very personal. Each ink company really has one leading ink maker, and they have a philosophy on how they want to make ink. For me, it's always about pressman friendly. I want that ink to be easy for the pressman to use, so there's always a challenge to making ink. Printing ink is used to print a wide variety of things, everything from packaging for food, for product, for parts. But color is really what sells printing ink. Everything you see that's on a paper-like substance has been printed with ink. Most of what we make here is process ink. That's a four-color system: yellow, magenta, cyan, and black. Black is the last color in the four-color process, and that just adds all the highlights, all the detail. Printing ink is composed of two primary things: a pigment, which is the color, and the vehicle, which is the carrier of the color. The pigment can be anything: a yellow, magenta, cyan, black, the colors we've talked about. It's a colored powder, and we need to incorporate that into vehicle, which is really like a sticky, gooey varnish. Not unlike honey, but of course an industrial honey. Some parts of the vehicle are thick and gooey, very sticky, very non-flowing. Other are thin, 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 like the thinnest water. When we start making ink in production, we weigh these into a pot, and then they get put onto a mixer. They are heated by mixing until they are much thinner than they would otherwise be at room temperature. It's at this point we can incorporate in the pigment. We need it to not be a fine powder flying around. We need it to be a liquid to run through our machines. So the next step in ink making is the grinding. Well, it's traditionally called grinding, but really it's a dispersion. We have these pigment particles that come to us as a dry powder, and a bunch of pigment particles are stuck together. We want to maximize those reflecting surfaces, so we want to break those lumps of pigment apart. And to do that, we have two types of machines. We have a bead mill. A bead mill has many, many little steel balls in it, and they impact on this pigment particle, and they'll break pigment particles off of this lump. But it gives us a very rough grind. We don't get a smooth, high gloss. It's a wonderful developing color, but we think the three-roller mill is the best for developing gloss. A three-roller mill is more of a traditional ink maker's tool. It is three large steel rollers running in opposite directions. This imparts a great deal of shear on pigment particles and basically smears them apart. It is the very, very best for making my kind of ink, as it imparts the most gloss and the most color strength. So the next step in making ink is quality control, or QC as we like to call it. It ensures that the ink is the same batch to batch. The very first test we'll do after the ink is run through the bead mill and through the three roller mill is a grind test. We want to ensure that every pigment particle has been reduced to its smallest possible size. This ensures a smooth, even print. We want it shiny and bright. The most important test we do is the bleach test. We incorporate a small amount of ink into opaque white. This allows us to check the color strength, because this allows our color computer to see whether the color has been developed. Once the dispersion is approved by my quality control technicians, it is then taken to the mixer. At this stage, extra ingredients are added. Things like waxes, which impart rub resistance. Things like dryers, which allow the ink to turn to a solid film in a relatively short period of time. Another important QC test we do is called a tack. This measures how sticky the ink is. We control the tack in an ink to ensure that the printer gets the same result. A stickier ink, a tackier ink, will transfer differently than a thinner or less tacky ink. One of the other things we do here is we intermix Pantone colors. We need to do this because, again, the color gamut of the yellow, magenta, cyan, and black is not enough to satisfy all of the color variation that designers want. By mixing together the base colors of the Pantone, we can give this array of color to satisfy any color demands. And if these colors aren't enough, we have a full color matching lab where we can match just about anything on any paper. After the final QC process, the ink is now ready to be packaged. We can everything over a 3-roller mill. This takes out the air and imparts even more gloss and polishing to the ink. The ultimate ink would have the best gloss, the best running ability, the best set speed, the best rub resistance. I may never find that ink, but every day I'm looking for the next piece to get me there. Once the ink is in the can, it has now been through 3 grinding mills, 2 mixers, 5 QC tests, and we're confident and happy to put our label on it and ship it to our customer. Well, you can see there's a lot more to ink making than just mixing two things together. There's a lot of craftsmanship, there's a lot of science, and there's a lot of passion.